Yes, good afternoon, my dear students. So today we'll discuss the morphology of flowering plant part 2 question paper. The first question is, in this flower can be divided into two equal radial halves in any radial plane passing through the center. So this means it is the actinomorphic. Actinomorphic. Okay, actinomorphic means we can divide the flower into two halves in any plane. So the correct answer is mustard. Mustard is the correct answer. Okay, so in the mustard we can divide the flower into two equal halves, whereas pea and bean, it is a zygomorphic. It is a zygomorphic flower. And the canna. Canna is a flower. It is a symmetry. A symmetry flower will be there. Okay. So here we cannot be divide the flower into two equal parts. So it is called as a symmetry. The next question, the correct answer is mustard. Then the second question is, when ovules develops on the inner wall of the ovary, the type of placentation is. So in the inner wall of the ovary means that is the parietal. So inner wall of the ovary, here the ovules are develops. So this type of placentation is called as parietal. Whereas in the axial placentation, the ovules are born on the central axis. The ovules are develops on the central axis. Okay, free central. So here it consists the false septum. Here in the free central, it consists the false septum. So in this one, the ovules are arranged. That is called as free central. So this twisted is a estivation. Twisted is a estivation. Then the correct answer is parietal placentation. The next one is type of estivation shown by the pisum is. Pisum is a plant. Pisum is a plant that is called as a pea plant. Pea plant. In the pea plant, it will shows bexillary estivation. In the pea plant, it will shows bexillary estivation. Okay, bexillary estivation means it consists. Vexillary estivation means it consists of 5 petals. In that one big petal is there, that is called as standard. And 2 smalls are there, that is called as wings. And 2 more smalls are there, that is called as key. Okay, in this one, what happens? The standard will cover the wings and keel. Okay, so standard is completely outside. okay, keels are completely inside, the wings are in and out. So such estivation is called as vexillary estivation, and this will be seen in the pisum, that is the Fabaceae family. Okay, the next, valvate estivation. Valvate estivation means here the sepals or petals, the margin of the sepals or petals are just present side by side or just touch to one another without overlapping. That is called as valvate estivation. Then imbricate estivation means the one of the petal is completely inside. And three sepals or petals is completely in and out. Okay, the three sepals and petals are in and out, and one is completely outside. So this is called as imbricate estivation. The next, twisted means the one of the margin is inside and another margin is outside. That is, in and out the estivation will be comes. So this is called as twisted estivation. Okay, here the pisum will shows the vexillary estivation, that is the vexillary. The next, normally the anthers are, so normally the anthers are bilobed. Normally the anthers are bilobed. Okay, in all the plants the anthers will be bilobed, whereas the in some plant, particularly in the China rose, the anthers are monolobed. In the China rose, the anthers are monolobed. That is called as monothecous, whereas it is called as dithecous. In all the plant, the anthers are dithecous or bilobed, whereas in the China rose, the anthers are monolobed or monothecous. So this is the correct answer. Okay. The next one is, among the following, that is plum, guava, rose, mustard, brinjal, China rose, cucumber, peach, sunflower. So how many plants have flowers with superior ovary? That is the hypogynous. That is the hypogynous ovary. Okay, the hypogynous ovary is in the mustard, brinjal and China rose will shows hypogynous, that is called as superior ovary. How many plants are here? 1, 2, 3. So the second option is correct. Okay. Whereas plum, rose, peach, these are the plant plum, rose, peach. So this will shows perigynous. Perigynous ovary, that is half inferior. This is the half inferior ovary. Okay, whereas guava cucumber, guava cucumber, sunflower, so these are having epigynous. Epigynous ovary, that is inferior. Inferior ovary is present. Okay, the correct answer is 3. Okay, the next question. Ovary is completely enclosed by thalamus. Completely. Okay, in. So this is the condition you can be see, you can be observed in the guava plant, where the thalamus is completely enclosed by the ovary. Okay, so here the ovary is epigynous. The ovary is epigynous. So this is the ovary. Okay, this ovary is completely covered by the thalamus. Okay, so such will be observed in the guava plant, whereas in the rose, that is the ovary is inserted or present, develops in the cup shape of the thalamus. Okay, so here it is in the rose, that is cup shape of the thalamus. The thalamus will cover, becomes cup shape, whereas in the China rose, the ovary will be present on the dome shape of the thalamus, that is in the China rose. Okay, in the plum also you can see the thalamus will becomes cup shape. So here this is the correct answer. The next, epigynous flowers are also known as flowers with, so epigynous flower, so that is called as half inferior. The flower is called as half inferior. Okay, then the hypogynous ovary is called as superior. Okay, the hypogynous is called as superior, the epigynous is called as inferior, and perigynous. Perigynous ovary is called as half inferior. So the correct one is inferior ovary. The next one, in a flower within a whorl, sepals or petals touch each other at margins without overlapping. Such flower is called as or seen in calotropies. So here it is a valvate estivation. Okay, in the calotropies, valvate estivation will be present where the margins will be touched to one another. Where the margins will be touched to one another. So that will be observed in the valvate estivation. Okay. The example for valvate is calotropy. Okay, the next one is called as P, and P, it is the plant, it will shows vexillary estivation. P will shows the vexillary estivation. Okay, then cassia, it will shows the imbricate estivation, and lady's finger, it will shows the twisted estivation. Twisted means the margins of the sepals and petals will be overlap one another with an order, in a definite order the margins will be overlap. So here the correct answer is 4, that is calotropies. The next, the edible part of the apple and pear is, so this apple and pears are a false fruit. Okay, the apple and pears are a false fruit. In that false fruit, the edible part will be developed from the thalamus. The edible part will be developed from the thalamus. Okay, so here the edible part is thalamus. Whereas in the mango, the edible part is mesocarp. Okay, in the apple and pears, the edible part is thalamus, whereas in the mango, the mesocarp is edible part. Whereas, so this is the condition. The correct answer is thalamus. The next one, so this is mesocarp is fibrous. Okay, in which fruit the mesocarp is fibrous? In mango, the mesocarp is juicy, whereas in the coconut or coconut or Coccus nucifera. So this, in this one, So the mesocarp is fibrous. Okay, so that correct answer is both A and B. So this coconut is the common name and Coccus nucifera is the scientific name. Okay, Coccus nucifera is the scientific name. So from this coccus or coconut, the fibers are extracted. So that is the mesocarp. Okay, in the coconut, it is called as stony fruit. The coconut is called as stony fruit because the endocarp, is hard. The endocarp is hard, so that it is called as stony fruit. The next one is the 11th one, the non-endospermic monocot is, okay, all these are the monocots, but here what happens, in the castor it is a dicot, tomato is dicot, maize is monocot and orchids are monocot. So in these plant, what happens, the endosperms are present, castor and maize. The endosperms are present, whereas in the orchids, endosperm is absent. Whereas in the orchid, endosperm is absent, so that the orchids are called as non-endospermic monocots. The next, scutellum is a part of, okay, scutellum is a part of monocot embryo. Okay, scutellum is a part of monocot embryo. It is also be called as cotyledon. It is also be called as cotyledon. So in the monocot, only one cotyledon is present. So that is monocot. So that cotyledon is called as scutellum. Okay. The next, in cereals like wheat rice etc, seeds are dashed with dash cotyledons. This is the wheat and rice. Wheat and rice are monocots. If it is monocots, means almost all the monocots are endospermic. Almost all monocots are endospermic. So here this is the endospermic, and all monocots consist one cotyledon. So all the monocots consist one cotyledon, so that it is called as endospermic and one. So the correct answer is endospermic and one. Okay, so the wheat and rice etc seeds are endospermic with one cotyledon. The next one, so here the accessory organs are, so accessory organs are called as calyx and corolla. So why it is called as accessory? because they are not directly, they are not directly take part in reproduction. So they are not directly take part in the reproduction, so that they are called as accessory whorls, but helps in reproduction and helps in reproduction. So it is called as accessory organs. Whereas the androecium and gynoecium, androecium and gynoecium is called as essential organ, because that will help in the reproduction. So these are called as essential organs, and these are helpful in the reproduction. Those are called as accessory organs. Okay. The next, vexillary estivation is the characteristic features of the family. So vexillary estivation is the characteristic features of Fabaceae. In the Fabaceae family, always vexillary estivation will be there. In the family Fabaceae, always vexillary estivation will be there. Okay. The next, the largest and most phylogenetically advanced family in angiosperm is Fabaceae. It is the largest and most advanced family in the angiosperm. The next, one is called as lupin. Lupin belongs to family Fabaceae. Lupin belongs to family Fabaceae, and this is ornamental plant. The lupin is a ornamental plant which is present in the Fabaceae family. Along with this lupin, it consists sweet pea. Along with this, the sweet pea is also used as an ornamental purpose. Okay. The next one, Indigofera, it is also belongs to Fabaceae. From this Indigofera, the dye will be extracted. Okay. The next, indigo dye is obtained from an angiosperm plant, Indigofera, which set of angiospermic plant belongs to the same angiospermic family. to which Indigofera belongs. So this Indigofera belongs to Fabaceae family. Okay, so this Fabaceae family consists soybean and susbenia. The soybean and susbenia are belongs to the Fabaceae family. So aloe vera belongs to tulip, belongs to Liliaceae family. Belladonna belongs to Solanaceae. Petunia belongs to Solanaceae family. Okay, but the susbenia and soybean belongs to Fabaceae family. Next, which feature is incorrect regarding the angiospermic family lilies? In the Liliaceae family, seeds are many and endospermic. It is correct. Androsiums are six, that is called as stamens. It is correct. But they are arranged in 3+3 manner. They are arranged in 3+3 manner. Okay, so perianth. So here the perianth are six tepals are there. They are also arranged in 3+3 manner. Okay, they are endospermic seeds. There are many seeds are there. The Liliaceae consists androsium six. That six are called as stamens. And they are arranged in 3+3 manner. So here the calyx and corolla is not differentiated. That is called as perianth. And that perianths are three. And those six, those are called as tepals. And these six tepals are arranged in 3+3 manner. Whereas the flowers are actinomorphic. The flowers are actinomorphic, but here the flowers are zygomorphic. So that the correct answer is flower. That is the fourth option is correct one. Okay, the next. Atropine used for dilating the pupil is obtained from Atropa belladonna, which is the member of angiospermic family. Okay, this Atropa belladonna belongs to Solanaceae family, and this Atropa Atropa belladonna belongs to or are used as medicinal purpose. Okay, Atropa belladonna will be used as medicinal purpose. And one more example is ashwagandha. Ashwagandha. So this ashwagandha is also be used for medicinal purpose to cure the diseases. Okay, ashwagandha is the plant. It will also used for the medicinal purpose. So here this Atropa belladonna belongs to Solanaceae family. The next, select the estivation shown in the diagram with example. Okay, so this is the imbricate and cassia. So imbricate and cassia example. The estivation is imbricate and the example for is cashier. Okay. Next, which family is represented by the diagram below? Okay, so this is the floral diagram of Solanaceae family. So in this one, 5 sepals, 5 petals are present. So that is called as 5 sepals and 5 petals. Okay. The next one. Identify the placentation from the given diagram and give one example each. So this is A is called as exile placentation. And the example is citrus. Okay. B is called as basal placentation, because here the seeds are attached to the base, that is basal placentation. And for this basal placentation, sunflower is there. Sunflower is example. And the one more example is also be there, that is the wheat. Wheat is also basal placentation. And free central placentation, the example is primrose. Okay, the one more example is selene is an one more example. The correct answer is the exile placentation, example is citrus. B is basal placentation, example is sunflower or the wheat. And C is the free central and the primrose. In the free central, the septum is absent, whereas in the exile, the septum is present. In this free central, the septum is absent. Then add the missing floral organs in the given formula of family. So here, this is the, which family consists zygomorphic flowers? That is the Fabaceae. This is the zygomorphic. Okay, bisexual. And calyx 5 which are fused. The next, corolla. That is 5. They are arranged in 1 plus 2 plus 2 manner, that is standard wings keel. So these keels are fused. So this is the correct answer. The next one, zygomorphic flowers with axillary estivation, diadelphus androecium, marginal placentation occurs in. Okay, so axillary estivation means pisum. Okay, then marginal placentation means the Fabaceae. Marginal placentation means Fabaceae, means in the Fabaceae family, the axillary estivation will be there, diadelphus conditions will be there, means the anthers are arranged in 2 bundles. This is one and this is two bundle, that is called as diadelphus condition, and the placentation is marginal, that is the pisum setiform. Okay, the next one, the standard petals of Papilionaceous corolla is also be called as vexillum. So this is the standard petal So this is called as standard petal. So this standard petal is also be called as vexilla. In the lily, stamens are present in, so that is epiphyllous condition. In the epiphyllous means the anthers are attached to the perianth. That is called as epiphyllous. So in pea, castor and maize seeds, the number of cotyledons are, in the pea, 2 cotyledons are there, castor, 2 cotyledons are there, maize, 1 cotyledon, that is 2, 2, 1. The first option is correct. Okay. The fruit development from the single ovary is said to be simple fruit, because the ovary single means the fruit will be simple. The next, non-essential floral organs without differentiation of calyx and corolla is called as perianth. In the monocot, the sepals and petals are not differentiated. The next, the point of attachment of seeds with the stalk is called as hilum. So the attachment of seeds with the stalk is called as hilum. This is the seeds and this is the attachment. So this structure is called as hilum. Plumule is covered by the protective sheath is called as coleopetal. The covering of the plumule is called as coleopetal, and the covering of the radical is called as coleorhiza. So this K represents sepals. If represented like this, means that is sepals are free. Okay, if it is represented like this, means sepals are fused. So this is called as fused sepals. Then fused sepals is called as gamosepals. The embryonal axis above the cotyledon is called as epicotyle. Above the cotyledon is called as epicotyle. Below the cotyledon is called as hypocotyle. A typical dicotyledonous embryo consists of radical, embryonal axis and cotyledons. Okay. Expression gynoecium is apocarpus implies that. So apocarpus means the carpels are free. Apocarpus means carpels are free. Syncarpus means carpels are fused. That is, gynoecium comprise more than one carpels which are free. So staminoid means that is the sterile anther. If the anther is sterile, it will not produce the pollen grains. Usually the whorls in a flower that attract the insect and protect the essential parts is, for the attraction, corolla is there. Okay. The next one, match the following and choose the correct option. Aleurone layer, it is used for the nutrition, A3. So it is A3. The second option is correct. Okay. The next, drupes are called stony fruits because they have hard endocarp. Find out correctly matched pair. Okay, so marginal tomato is a central, parietal it is a primrose, primrose is a free central, exile that is lemon or the sun lemon or the China rose, but the basal is sunflower. Okay. Mature seeds of plants such as grams and peas possess no endosperm because endosperm will be get used up by the developing embryo during the seed development. Next, which of the following option is correct about the family Solanaceae? Okay, in the Solanaceae family, the flowers are pentamerous, means sepals and petals are five, bisexual flower, actinomorphic and hypogynous. Okay, the next, many pulses of the daily use belongs to one of the family below, which is the correct one, that is the Fabaceae. Okay, so all these are the answers. Thank you.
एक बंदा इधर